It's 2020, and someone, somewhere, has decided this is not humankind's year.
The country's been ablaze, we are heading into a recession, and we aren't allowed to hug anyone anymore.
The last thing anyone needs is a financial stressor.
Unfortunately, emergencies don't wait for a good day to occur, but their pain can be lessened by good planning.
One simple way you can make extra savings every month is by checking the bank account records for subscriptions that you barely use. My name is Matthew, and I'm spending $100 on subscriptions that I don't use. Are you still holding on to your HBO subscription after finishing Game of Thrones? How about a gym membership that you're underutilizing? Well, you're not alone. After I clear those subscriptions, I was saving an additional $100 every month, and you can too.
A second way you can protect yourself from expensive accidents you can't control is insurance. My name's Bridie, and 2 weeks into the pandemic, my car broke down in literally the most obtrusive part of the road. So it did not help to have loud horns and angry drivers yelling at you as you're trying to figure out what to do. Thankfully, I had car insurance. So in one quick call, they were able to come control traffic, tow my car to a shop, and replace parts of the engine. When I first looked at the invoice for over $10,000 worth of services, my heart sunk at the idea of being forced to take out one of those payday loans, which I knew used high interest rates and harsh deadlines, which end up making you pay way more than the cost of the initial repair. Thankfully, the invoice actually showed what the car insurance covered. And because I paid car insurance, I only had to pay a small excess fee of a few hundred dollars instead of way over $10,000.
A third way that you can protect yourself financially from events such as Bridie's happening is by having an emergency fund. An emergency fund is a sum of money set aside when financially adverse events do occur, such as losing your job in the current COVID-19 crisis. Hi, my name is Maddie, and earlier this year my laptop died, leaving me with the stress of having to purchase a new one. How did I buy a new laptop? Well, luckily I had an emergency fund set aside when things like this do occur. I didn't have to go and borrow money and go into debt. An emergency fund differs for each person, depending on your spending habits and income. For a rough guide on how much to save, look at how many months you want to protect yourself for. So look at your monthly expenditure and multiply this by how many months you would like to protect yourself. This way, when financially adverse events do occur, you have a safety net to fall into.
Bridie and Maddie, perhaps a loan would help you, but be careful. Avoid taking on loans during financial hardships, but if this is your only option, take precautions when going about it. Before taking on any loans, I recommend you consult a financial counselor who will help you deal with the situation and work out an appropriate course of action. If you have trouble repaying a loan, you can look for them too. Don't be confused with financial advisors who instead help you grow your wealth. Well, that's all from us. Take care and smash your debts.